I made that a bit strong. There.
He has fought hard and very, very long. Rest will take him in time. Much has changed since we met. You have grown in strength. The root have tasted fear. It is a feeling unfamiliar to them. This world will not recover, traveler. What the root have taken cannot be returned. Yet, we live. You have given us that. I have lost much. To fare at all is well, child.
I'm not in the mood for chat.
Oh, traveler. Be safe out there.
Okay. Just like put me back in the same spot. Cause, I mean, there was a checkpoint down by what's his face, but I don't know. It's here.
Really?
Oh, fuck.
Thank you.
But I got a trait point! So cool, I guess. Too soon. I sucked. Because, like, I hit him manually, so, yeah, that'll do it.
Thank you.
better fucking run! Good boat. I thought his boat was destroyed. Oh, it's a different one. Praise the gun! Mm. If that's Kenneth Basham or Bassam. It's just no music, no nothing, just quiet. Okay. Marcus Luna de Leon. Gustavo Lamas. Nali, or is it sodium lithium? Merchant.
Lekin Mazant.
Huh.
Sir.
Yeah.
I finally got to the ending at... Lekin Mazant said, how yeah, like all those questions it answered.
Hum Nom Workshop. Yeah, the ending didn't really have anything besides, you know, tower collapses, hero gets out, ooh. My bigger complaint is that the ending just felt anticlimactic. They could have done a lot more. Anything from the protagonist, like watching him walk out and kind of like, you know, the entire fucking place didn't have to collapse and then just cut to black and then he finds the boat. Like, I thought it would have been better to have the dreamer die and then just have him like take off his helmet and watch him like walk and make his way out and kind of, you know, a slow ponder on everything that's happened. That would have been more meaningful than what they showed. As far as questions answered, I don't know. I was expecting that some way the protagonist was going to have to die when Ford said something like, you know, you'll see that the sacrifice is worth it. I didn't really see what the big deal was. Besides that, I don't know. A lot, like, I felt that the majority of what was happening was wrapped up.
Lekin Mazant said, agreed. I was pissed they didn't explain anything about what the dreamers actually were, what the meaning of them was, what happened to Ford after Yisha, and what the actual fuck are the root.
Well,
Lekin Mazant said, luckily the subject 2293 DLC goes into all of it, but I was annoyed I had to pay extra for exposition I felt was lacking in the main game.
I have a cat at the door, I think. I don't know, I didn't mind that much. The root, I mean, to me it seems like they're just a dimensional plague. As soon as we get to the menu or load in or whatever, I'm gonna grab my cat and we're gonna give me just a moment here. What? There we go. Cat cam. I don't know. There are a lot of questions that were not outright answered, but solutions were implied. At least enough that I felt was fine. Because a lot of the shit that was going down, I felt like not even Ford or the rest of them had proper answers to. You got another one in your back. These are what gets in his fur. And they have little micro barbs on them, so they only go one way.
Said, I suppose. I just found the lore interesting and wanted them to give me more of it.
That's fair enough. Wish I could get some more light on him, but he's just so dark.
Said. So what is the plan now?
I don't know. I'm gonna play something else. Right now I'm just letting him stay in here until he gets tired and decides he wants to leave again, because that's what he do. Look at the murder feet on this dude. I will check my library, see if there's anything else that I can throw down on. Was that a funny noise? You are dirty. You need a bath. You gotta clean yourself better. Yeah, you. Yeah, you. If he decides he wants to peace out before I find a game, then I'm gonna just kill the stream and pick something. And if I find something, then I'm just gonna wait until he decides he wants to peace out and then swap over to that. Dude, you got hair in my nose. Not cool. Oh, sorry. Squish your foot. Didn't mean to. You know I didn't mean to. What you looking at? What you looking at?
Now you're making a mess. Way to go.
Shame I can't bring the mic closer so you can hear his purring.
Oh, you're so comfy, huh? Listen, don't plan on going to sleep there, okay? Because I'm going to move you if you do.
Lekin Mazant said, my kitty is usually on my tower, lol.
My tower is way up here and up.
Said, enjoying the warmth from my power supply.
My tower is way up in a cabinet thing. And it doesn't have enough space for him to climb on it. If he did, he'd have fans yanking his hair out, so. That's not for him.
Man, I'm going to have to take an allergy pill after this because of you. Hope you're happy.
Of course he is. He's pleased. He's fucking pleased. I could try another game that has a similar aesthetic. Doing? Leave my headphones alone. Don't you dare. Oh. I don't know if you heard that. So don't you dare. He goes, yeah.
Can't eat them, so you're not interested?
Lekin Mazant said, LMAO. Lekin Mazant said, my cat does that too.
Now he's sitting over by the door waiting to be let out. Well, I have an idea. There's actually one thing I was thinking about earlier. There have been updates to Streamlabs, so I might be able to capture Nier Automata without having to play it windowed. It would be nice to get back to that. And it's still installed. So I think what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to kill my... Oh man, he left more seeds on my desk. Ah! I don't think there was any hair in my drink. I hope not. So, yeah. I'm going to kill this. I'm going to let him out. gonna grab a smoke, and then I'm gonna see if I can get near Automata to play nice with Streamlabs. If not, I'll fire up something else. Because I like it, but... man... playing it windowed, it takes such a hit. It's garbage. It really frustrates me. So... we'll see. Yeah, I know that there were a few things that Streamlabs couldn't screen grab that they've
said. Did you ever play VTM?
What is VTM? If I've played it, I'm not familiar with the analogy.
Lekin Mazant said, https://.
Oh, Vampire the Masquerade. No, no, I have not.
/app/2600/vampire_the_masquerade_bloodlines.
I know a lot of people like it, but it's one that I've never really been that into, you know. If I were to play the tabletop edition, maybe? But as a computer game, no, not really.
Lekin Mazant said, AHH, I figured with the heavy tabletop focus you'd dig it. It literally even has a character sheet in the game, lol. Lekin Mazant.
Alright, buddy, I'll let you on in a second. Said, keep your tail on.
But I gotcha.
Yeah. No, tabletop is different because it's more freeform, you know? And I have heard from different people some of the oversights in the game. One of the biggest ones being, again, a gripe I always have.
Yes, you'll be out in a minute. Hold on.
That, again, like Fallout. You can't just make a character the way that you want. There are certain things that you have to put points into, and then others that are just completely worthless. So, I don't know. Oh, I made that too strong.
Lekin Mazant said, "No, you are not wrong." Lekin Mazant said, "At a certain point, there's a lot of combat."
I think people were griping that you put points Lekin in like Mazant charisma and it doesn't work out that said, much.
And if you don't have anything in combat, the game is very difficult.
But anyway, I'm going to kill the stream here. I'm going to play with Streamlabs and Nier. I'll see what I can do. I'll be back soon.